Morning, everyone. Welcome to the live newsletter, and I'm coming here live from our 8th tee box. And the reason why I'm standing on the 8th tee box is to talk a little bit about the river that we have and the status of the river. So I've been asked a couple of times about the status of the river. Obviously, you understand that it's one of the biggest gripes you have at the club. The litter that comes from upstream really, really causes a lot of problems for the club. And to keep it clean has got quite a financial impact on the club. So we have got some information in terms of the river. We do have the Hinops Blue Horizon group who is working on the river, which is a much bigger group that assists with the project and also to try and see if they can assist in cleaning the river and also educating people in terms of the river. So if you need any information in terms of the river, please go to hinopsblue.co.za and please go onto their website, have a look at what they do. If you do have a contribution to give them from a financial perspective, they are looking for some financial support, and I'm sure they will appreciate it, and we also appreciate whatever you can give them. The impact that it has on the club, and not just ourselves, but the whole river that goes down all the way through to Centurion Mall and further down to the Swartkops Golf Club, is in quite a state. And as a club, we try and keep it as clean as we can. But we clean it, and it could rain the next day, and we could have exactly the same problem again. And as I said previously, the financial impact on the club really is quite difficult. We try and clean it with our staff as much as we can, and try on a regular basis to see if we can keep it as clean as possible. So if you really need more information, please go to that website, www.enopsblue.co.za, and assist them as well to keep our community clean in terms of the river. Moving off that, from some club perspective, the 10th of December, we will be having a staff day. So that is a Monday. We'll be closing the club. All the facilities will be closed, from food and beverage, the golf course, everything will be closed, so we can look after our staff a little bit for all the hard work they did this year. And just to say a small thank you from the club side to the staff. The rock bottom special for tomorrow night is fish and chips, 65 Rand. We also closed on the 25th of December, which is Christmas. So please take note of that. We also only do a half day on the 24th in the morning, only a morning field. And we also do only a half day on New Year's Eve, which is the 31st of December. So please take note of those dates. We will put it through on our club newsletter as well. And then thank you to everybody that joined us for Sundowners this last Friday night. We tried a different venue, we tried it under the trees, and it turned out to be quite a successful night where people stayed quite late and listened to the band. So thank you very much for everybody that supported us throughout the year for the Sundowners. It is turning out to be a very social function for the club, where all the members can get together, the community can get together and actually participate and interact with each other. The next Sundowners will only start in the new year, so this was our last one. And the new year will probably start somewhere in February, but we will communicate through to you in terms of that as well. We've also invoiced all our members in terms of the new packages. So from all our sports sections, inclusive of golf, we've now put through the packages. If you need information, if you haven't received anything from Michelle yet, please contact us. You can contact Michelle on michelle@irenecc.co.za, and she'll be able to assist you with that process as well. We will also put it in our newsletters this week with regards to all the information that I'm talking about currently. We've also had a request from one of our members, the Jan Smuts Trophy, or the Jan Smuts Memorial Trophy. It's a big shield. Gary Farias asked us just to ask the membership if they know where that trophy is. We don't have it at the club, and we would like to see if any of the members do have it, either at their homes or if they know the whereabouts of that trophy. We would like to get it back to the club, as it is quite a traditional thing for the club. So if anybody has information with regards to the Jan Smuts Memorial Trophy, we would appreciate it if you just contact us in terms of that. So thank you very much. Thanks for listening to me, and we will see you next week.